In this video, you'll learn how to classify soils using the AASHTO classification system. I'll go through every detail that goes into this table. And at the end, hopefully you have learned how to read it and use it to be able to classify soils with it. Previously in this channel, we talked about arabic limits and soil gradations. If you haven't watched those videos, I'll put links to them in the description as well as somewhere on the screen. And now it's time to talk about how to classify soils. There are primarily two classification systems, USCS and AASHTO. USCS is mainly used on most of the projects that involve highways and buildings. However, the AASHTO system is primarily used in the highway design projects. So in this video, I'm going to start with the particle size definition in AASHTO. Then, as I said earlier, I'll go through the AASHTO classification table and I'll show you every single part of that table. Then I'll show you the soil classification chart that you might not have seen before, but it is really helpful to understand the classification system. Then I'll go through the group index, and I'm going to end with some tips for exams as well as a couple examples. AASHTO defines particles based on their grain size and plasticity. According to AASHTO, the boundary between fine-grained particles, which are silt and clay, and coarse-grained particles, which are sand and gravel, is sieve number 200, which has an opening size of 0.075. The boundary between sand and gravel is sieve number 10, which has an opening size of 2 millimeter. And finally, the boundary between gravel and cobbles and boulders is 75 millimeters, which is equal to 3 inches. There are three numbers that you need to remember here: 0.075, 2, and 75 millimeters. AASHTO divides clay and silty soils based on their plasticity index. PI of 10 is the boundary between these two materials. I've also seen in some references and some state DOTs that these two materials are also divided based on their grain size, and 0.002 millimeter is defined as the boundary of them. And here is the AASHTO classification table, which I'm sure you've seen it before. Let's first take a look at different parts of this table. At the top of the table on the second row, the group classifications are listed, which are A1s, A3, and A2s for granular soils, and A4, 5, 6, and A7s for silty clay soils or cohesive soils, and finally A8, which is peat and highly organic soils. The next two parts are the grain sizes and plasticities that we just talked about. The next row is basically how we usually describe these soils. For example, A3 is fine sand. And finally, on the last row, you see subgrade ratings for different soil classifications. Now let's take a closer look at different parts of the table, starting with the grain sizes. You just learned, based on AASHTO, sieve number 200 is the boundary between silty and clay soils and gravelly and sandy soils. Now the question is, what percentage of the material, if passed through this sieve, we have either of these soil types? You intuitively might think it's 50%, but it is not. It is 35%. Based on AASHTO, if more than 35% of the soil or material passes through sieve number 200, we have silty or clay soils. And if less than or equal to 35% passes through sieve number 200, we have granular soils. This is also included here in the table. Here is sieve number 200. Here is the boundary of 35%. And you can see we have more than 35% on the right and less than or equal to 35% on the left side of this boundary. The next sieve that we have in the table is sieve number 40. And as you can see down here in the table, this sieve is the boundary between coarse and fine sand. This boundary is right here in the table. And as you can see, it is 50%, meaning that if more than 50% of the material passes through sieve number 40, we have a fine sand which includes A3 and A2s. And on the other hand, if less than 50% of the material passes through sieve number 40, we have coarse sand as well as gravel. And the last sieve that we have in the table is sieve number 10, which is the boundary between gravel and sand. This boundary is right here in the table, and it is again 50%, meaning that if more than 50% of the material passes through this sieve, we have sandy soil. And if less than 50% of the material passes through this sieve, we have gravelly soil. In the lower portion of this table, we have plasticities. You saw earlier that plasticity index of 10 is the boundary between clay and silt. This boundary is right here in the table. Any soil with PI of more than 10 can be clay soil, and any soil with PI of less than 10 can be silty soil, as well as sandy or gravelly soils. Here are a few other points about the plasticity portion of the table. For A3 and A1s, liquid limit does not matter. For A3, PI is non-plastic, which is defined as any PI of less than 4. For A1s, the PI should be maximum 6. And finally, all the way at the right side of this table, you see A7 is divided to A75 and A76. This division is done based on plasticity limit. And here are the definition. Plasticity limit of less than 30 is A76, and plasticity limit of equal or more than 30 is A75. And this was everything, almost everything, that you needed to know about this table to be able to use it. And the only thing that is left off is liquid limit and how this row is used here, which we are going to cover it when we go through the soil classification chart here. The chart basically helps us to visualize the plasticity portion of the table. We have plasticity index in the table, which is the vertical axis of the chart. And the main value here is 10%. We also have liquid limit in the table, which is the horizontal axis of the chart. And its main value is 40%. And lastly, we have this line, which represents the two A7s that we have in the table, which are defined based on the plasticity limit of 30%. Now let's quickly see where all of these soil classes are located on the chart. A24 and A4 are on the bottom left. A25 and A5 are on the bottom right. A26 and A6 on the top left. A27 and A7s on the top right. And this is how A76 and A75 are divided based on the plasticity limit line of 30%. Before we move on, here is a quick and helpful takeaway from this chart, which is within a similar liquid limit and plasticity index ranges, the second number of a sandy soil classification matches the first number of a silty or clay soil classification. Here are two examples of what I just said to better understand it. And finally, group index, which is used for evaluation of the quantity of a soil to be used as a highway subgrid. Here is the equation of the group index, which has two portions. The first one is called the partial group index determined based on liquid limit. And the second one is called the partial group index determined based on the plasticity index. In this equation, F200 is the percent passing sieve number 200. There are some rules in determining the GI. If the calculated GI using the equation is less than zero, which is mainly the case for these classifications, the GI should be assumed to be equal to zero. There is no upper boundary for GI, and it can be any number, any positive number. And as a matter of fact, the quality of performance of a soil for a subgrade is inversely proportionate to the GI, meaning that the closer the GI to zero, the better quality material it is, and the higher the GI, the poorer quality it is going to be. GI should be rounded to the nearest whole number. And finally, for calculating GI for A26 and A27, PGI equation, which is the second portion of the equation, should be used. And for silty and clay material, the GI equation shall be used to calculate GI. And here are some simple tips to more efficiently use this table. The first one is identifying the particle sizes. What are the percentage passing sieve number 10, 40, and 200? And once we know the last one, we know which side of the table we should be looking at. Then we need to know what is the liquid limit and what is the plasticity index. Once we know these two, and we know which side of the table we should be looking at, we need to start moving from the top left to the bottom right of each side, or this side that we are at, and use the process of elimination to find the classification of the sample that we have. And lastly, we need to calculate the GI or PGI. So this was everything that you needed to know to be able to classify soils using the AASHTO method. And it's now time to practice. Here is the first example. As we just talked about it in the tips, the very first thing that we do is we look at the percent passing sieve number 200. And in this case, it's 58%. Now, is it more than 35%? Yes, it is. So we are on the right side of this table. Do we need to look at the percent passing sieve number 10 and 40? No, we do not, because on this side of the table, there is no constraints for these two sieves. And we can just jump into the plasticity section of the table. Liquid limit of 30. We can say that A5 and A7s are gone, and we are only left with A4 and A6. Plasticity index of 10. A6 is gone. So the answer to this question is A4. And I'll let you calculate the GI for this soil, but it's going to be 3. Here is the second example. I'll pause for a second so you can do it yourself. All right. The first thing that we do again is looking at the material that passed sieve number 200. We have 20%. So obviously we are in the granular soils side. We are going to start from the very top row of the table, sieve number 10. We have 80%. So we're not on A1A side, but our soil sample can be anything on the right side of the table or the granular soils side. So to narrow things down more, we look at sieve number 40. We have 45%. So you can see 45% is going to eliminate anything that is on A13 and on the right side.
So we are at A1B, and this is our sample. And let's just double check the SIB number 220 works here. Liquid limit, we have non-plastic, which is good here. Plasticity index, we have non-plastic, which is good here. So our sample is A1B, and again, calculate the group index for this sample. So hopefully you enjoyed the video and you learn how to use this table to be able to classify soils using the AASHTO classification system. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave a comment down below. And if you enjoyed it and you think it's helpful for your friends, please feel free to share it with the others.